every now and again, I come across a system that has a problem, or I come across a question that needs a little bit of answering. So today, we're gonna go ahead and answer one of our viewers' questions because I think that this conversation could be useful to a lot of other homeowners. And a lot of times, this answer is usually something that's not a major problem, usually fairly easy to fix, but it could lead to other issues if not addressed. So let's go ahead, hop into what is this question and what can be going on here. So today we get ourselves a question from our good friend Victory First 2878. And the question is, what is the problem when the well pump motor turns on and you hear a loud bang noise? Is that a bad pressure tank bladder? Now, with that question, there comes a little bit of a caveat. There can be a lot of things that cause a weird bang noise, and I haven't heard your noise, nor have I seen your system. So this is going to be kind of a broad spectrum answer to what might possibly be going on for you. So the first thing we got to think, what happens when the pump turns on? If you're running a sink and you're watching the pressure tank, what do you see, right? Is it immediately, as soon as the pump turns on, you hear a bang noise? What kind of bang noise do you think it sounds like? The most common issue that I see to cause a noise in a well system is going to be when the pipes are not properly secured, whether that be secured to rafters, walls, whatever. As soon as the pump turns on, usually there's going to be a little bit of vibration to the piping. And if the pipes aren't connected to anything, what'll happen is it'll jiggle around. And a lot of times it can actually smack the rafters itself, or this one's the most common one. Let's say the HVAC guy put all of your, you know, ductwork next to the plumbing. If the plumbing itself is near the ductwork and it's not properly secured to something, as soon as that pipe moves, it can sometimes smack against the ducting. And that ducting can make quite a lot of noise that you can hear throughout the entire home. It's relatively easy to fix. All you do is you just go ahead and secure the pipe to either a rafter or whatever. As far as I'm aware, you're not supposed to connect anything to the rafters themselves, so you want to get it over to the wood side, and that way you don't have to worry about that. A lot of times I see this with piping that is made of plastic, so whether it be PVC or CPVC. Every now and again, you might see this with like PEX or copper, but for some reason, it always seems to be CPVC or PVC where people run into things jiggling and moving around. So let's talk about what happens if you don't do anything about this. Well, in most cases, nothing, right? But if your pipes are moving and having any kind of vibration to them, you are putting stress on all of your fittings. So what can happen is you might have a glue joint, you know, 6 feet away. You might have a threaded connection 10 feet the other direction. As the pipe's moving, you're putting stress on those joints. And those joints should, and usually do, survive that stress. However, you do run the risk of that, you know, movement causing that entire fitting to just pop off. And now you have a big problem with flooding in your basement. So in order to figure out if vibration is your problem or not, basically what I would recommend is just go ahead, leave on a sink and watch what's going on. First, I would always start with the pressure tank, and then I would follow the pipe back to where it comes through the foundation, going towards the well. And if that pipe's not moving, if all that looks good, the next step, I would go into the house and start looking, all right, where are my water lines going? When it's going to the water heater, your cold distribution throughout the entire house. Just kind of look at the piping and see where it is. If you see nothing, the next thing is to look and listen for where you hear the noise the loudest. Let's say that it's in the bathroom. Maybe you just recently remodeled your bathroom and the plumber didn't secure the piping in the bathroom's ceiling or the wall as correctly as they would want to. The other thing is you gotta think, well, what fixture are you running that when you turn on the pump or turn it on that you hear this noise? Let's say you have a constant pressure system. Well, a constant pressure system doesn't have the pump engage until you start running water. So if you turn on the shower and the pump engages, maybe your shower assembly is not secured properly and that's what's moving around. There's a variety of things that can be going on for this, but if you're really looking for something that's loose, you kind of have to run the water and listen and walk around the house until eventually you find whatever it is that's making the noise. Now, there are some small things that can be causing this problem that are not as common, but for example, let's say you have a bad check valve on your house plumbing as well as in the well. So if you have no check valve in the house, no check valve that's working in the well, what'll happen is every time that pump disengages, the water will flow back into the well. So that creates a gap to where when the pump turns on, now you're pushing air and it's basically air hammering or water hammering inside of the pipe. Not as common, not a super normal thing that you see happen, but it can be something that's going on. Generally, how you see if you've got a bad check valve or a leak in the line is you'll get like an air bubbly sensation, or like you'll get a dramatic drop off of water where the water runs, nothing, back up, and then you don't see it again, right? So let's just say that we have a leaking pitless adapter or a leak in our water line, but our check valve in the house works and our check valve in the well works. Basically, what will happen is the piping will empty out. So by the time this one turns on, the pump now has to fill the pipe and get it to the house. So you're going to have, you know, a 3 to 5 second delay, depending on your depth of your well and how far away your pipe is. The further away your pipe is from the home or deeper the well, obviously, the longer it's going to take for that water to fill the pipe. Having a bad check valve is not terribly difficult to fix, but it is way more inconvenient and a lot more work than just securing a pipe to a rafter. So if you find the check valve's not working or the pipe has a leak in it, now you're pulling up the pump or replacing piping, and it's just a lot more effort for a homeowner. Now, maybe you might be very handy, and honestly, it's really not that hard, but it does take time. So hopefully to fix your problem, all you have to do is just find where the pipe's shaking around and just secure it to the wall, or sorry, to the rafters. They sell perfect little fittings. If it's CPVC, they sell little tiny ones. You can get metal ones, you can get little standpipe ones that you can drill into the floor, to the ceiling that can hold it. There's a variety of ways to secure your fitting or your piping to the wall or the rafters or the floor or whatever you want to secure it to. If you go to Home Depot, you'll see all of these pieces that you can use to secure the piping in the plumbing section. Generally, it'll be right between the gas fittings and the PVC stuff. So it'll be somewhere in that ballpark. Usually it's gonna be right next to the glue, as well as the pipe dope and all of your Teflon tapes. So if you look over there, you should be able to find it. Hopefully this long-winded answer helps you figure out what's going on for your house. Usually if you hear a thumping noise, it's not gonna be the bladder though. The bladder will generally make like a hissing noise sometimes, but usually how you'll check is you'll get a quick cycle on the pressure switch. You'll get water that shoots out of the Schrader valve, which is a little tiny tire pressure, like access on top of the valve or on top of the pressure tank, and you'll notice a pulsation in the water. So if you've got no pulsation, you don't have water shooting out of the Schrader valve, and it's not short cycling, the odds of your pressure tank being the problem are low. I usually would think that it's going to be something to do with a loose pipe. If you've done all of this and you still can't figure it out, my best suggestion would be to consider contacting a local professional to help you identify the source of the issue. If it's not causing any immediate concerns, you know, you might be able to make it a lower priority, but you definitely don't want to let pipes vibrate and move around, because you do run a risk of that pipe eventually having a problem and you having a flooded basement and or bathroom wall, whatever, and nobody wants that. Like I said, just walk around, listen, see if you can figure out where that noise is coming from, and then kind of go from there on how you approach it. Hopefully this gave you enough information to at least know how to approach it and what kind of steps you can take to take care of everything. I hope you enjoyed this. If you guys are not used to this channel, I try to post content dealing with wells, septic systems, personal finance, home ownership, home maintenance, things like that, to try and help everybody improve. It's my goal to learn, and I want to help share the things that I know with you so that way you can learn. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button, hit subscribe, and I look forward to talking to you guys later.